Hi, this is Sunil. We are at this 3 kilowatt rooftop solar plant installed at JP Nagar, Bangalore. This system was commissioned on the 31st of October 2019. So this is a little over 2 years since this plant was commissioned. Today we are going to look at the performance of this plant over the last 2 years and analyze some of the data which we actually picked up from the Envoy, that is the data logger which comes with the system. This is a 3 kilowatt system with 8 panels of 375 watt peak monocrystalline PERC panel of Longisolar make and micro inverters of IQ 7 plus series of Enphase. So I am now sitting here on a walkway. This walkway is provided for cleaning the solar panels and for maintenance of the system. We also have automatic panel cleaning, but it is still important to have a walkway because once in a way one needs to come and clean it manually. As I explained, we have for this project we have used IQ 7 plus. 2 years back this was the latest series available from Enphase. This is the micro inverter. You can see here this inverter is actually fixed here. So there are 8 inverters connected in parallel. So let us just take a look at the inverter and the inverter termination point. So as you saw, there are 8 inverters connected in parallel. The wires from the 8 inverters terminates in this terminal block. This is the first level of protection. Here we have the cables coming from the inverters and the another set of cable which from here which goes to the LT panel down below. We will talk about protection in another exclusive video, but suffice to say here that you know in this level just below the panels we have given a MCB, SPD and a over voltage protection relay. This basically takes care of any surges or any kinds of over voltage coming from the grid and does not pass it on to the inverter. The output from here goes through the normal cable into our meter box, that's the LT panel of the house, which we will take a look at it now. So now we come to the electrical panel or the meter panel of the house. As I said, this system was commissioned on the 31st of October 2019. Today is 6th of December, so we are a little over 2 years since the system was commissioned. So this is the main electrical panel. So here we have the bidirectional meters and the other protections and the Envoy and everything here. I will quickly run through all these details. The output from that terminal block on the roof comes into the ELCB here. So we have got three protections, ELCB, MCB and 275 volts SPD here. So the solar output goes through these protections and gets into this meter. This is the unidirectional meter. This measures only the solar generation. Suppose if you want to check how much solar energy has been generated, we can use this meter as well apart from our software or the remote monitoring device. The output from this meter through this fuse and the CT, this CT is the production CT, that is to that this measures the solar production. The output from this meter through the fuse and the CT goes into the grid. So this is the grid side. The power from the grid through the bidirectional meter and the fuse and the consumption CT comes into this MCB. Our solar and the grid is integrated in this panel. So as I described, there are two meters. This is the generation meter. This measures the solar generation. And this is the bidirectional meter. We also have this system called as an Envoy. This is the data logger. This Envoy is used to communicate between the inverter and the cloud, and we can transmit, we can upgrade the system, we can update the system. So if you want to send some information to the system, we can do through this. If you have to retrieve some information, the daily production, monthly production, weekly production, there's a lot of data which gets captured in this Envoy, which can be seen either in the mobile app or the web app. So this is the bidirectional meter. The power from the grid comes into this bidirectional meter. The output from the bidirectional meter is connected to this fuse and there is a CT. This is the consumption CT. To measure our consumption in the house, we use this CT and this goes into the MCB. From here, it further gets distributed. So as I said, this Envoy here captures a lot of data in terms of daily production, monthly production, weekly production, consumption. So a lot of data is captured on this Envoy. So this meter, the generation side meter, gives the generation of the solar panels. So let us just try to cross check between this meter and our Envoy. So you can come closer. So this is my system here. So here we can see the energy. So how much is the energy being produced? So let me choose a lifetime. So this gives the lifetime energy production. So as per this the data on the Envoy, it says 8.6 MWh, that is about 8600 units of energy is being produced so far. So let us check that with the meter here. So let us run through this. So this says the production so far is 8633.7 units. This is the energy produced so far from this system. So now let us now check the bidirectional meter. The bidirectional meter gives the energy import and export over the course of the project. So let us check, see, as per our Envoy data, we have produced 8600 units, out of which the net exported after consuming is 3700, and we have also imported, that is the energy that we have taken from the grid when there was no sunshine, is about 3200 units. So let's run through these numbers in this meter. So let us scroll here. So here it says the import so far is 3308, almost matching 3200 with our Envoy data, and the export it says 6971. So the export here is 6900. So this is the energy which is exported to the utility grid. So in terms of billing, we have to deduct the export minus import to get the net energy, how much is either imported or exported. So for this system, the net energy is, we have actually given to the grid 3700 units, and the grid actually compensates us for this excess energy that we have injected into the grid. As I said, there is a lot more data actually the Envoy captures, and we'll be able to analyze this data for better and more robust designs. So let us take some of the data which has been captured over the last 2 years, analyze this data for the environment and the carbon footprint. We'll also analyze this for the economics of the project and see how best to design future projects using this data. So let us now look at a small presentation where we are going to run through a lot of data which has actually come from the Envoy and see what this data actually tells us. Thank you. So we'll now quickly run through some of the key data of this project. So this is our 3 kilowatt on-grid project. So this is, as I explained, this has got 8 panels of 375 watt peak and inverter of IQ7 plus of Enphase make. So this also couples up as a small office, and of course it's an agro photovoltaic system. So let's look at the energy review over the last 2 years. So the beauty of the microinverter is actually displayed in this slide. As you can see, there are 8 panels. So there are, since this we are using microinverters, there are 8 independent systems. So the data which we have picked up here is generation from each panel over the course of the last 2 years. So we can see each of these panels have produced so much of energy. So this is of course our data logger, which I just explained. And this is our energy production and consumption over the last 2 years. The blue gives us the energy production and the orange is our energy consumption. Over the last 2 years, we have reached once a peak of 17.9 units on a particular day, which translates into almost 6 units of energy on that particular day. So we will look at what's the carbon footprint or energy footprint of this project over the last 2 years. As per the app, it says, you know, this 8.6 or 8600 units is equivalent to about 156 trees, but one can refer to this very popular website used to actually get the carbon footprint. As per this website, our energy production of 8600 units roughly translates into about 101 trees, the carbon sequestered by 101 trees, and we are just talking about 2 years. So we can, this plant will at least run for another 20 years, so we can see, you know, what can be our energy footprint for the entire lifetime of this project. So this we can measure other matrices also, like, you know, what is it equal in terms of landfill, what is it in terms of trash, and so on and so forth. But we can say, okay, this project in the last 2 years has been equal into about 101 mature trees.
So we will now look at the economics of this project over the last 2 years, like what in terms of money does this project actually mean. So we have taken the energy production and consumption from this plant for the last 2 years, that is starting November 2019 to October 2021. We have taken the energy generated every month from the Envoy, energy consumed every month, and we have tried to do some numbers. So let us take a typical month, say November 2019. We have produced 325 units. We have consumed 111. So net energy is what we have produced minus what we have consumed. So we have actually done an excess of 214. There is a cost that actually that we have to bear for actually contracting a demand of 5 kilowatt. So a fixed cost of 340 is levied by the DISCOM for a contracted demand of 5 kilowatt. So this we have to pay irrespective of what we consume. And this column gives us what is the savings on electricity. That is, if we were not to be having solar, we would have actually had to pay 550 rupees at that prevailing tariff. Now, for the month of November 2019, the DISCOM pays us for the excess energy of 214 into 3.99. So BESCOM has to pay us a amount of 856 rupees for that particular month. However, we have to pay the DISCOM 340 rupees for the contracted load of 5 kilowatt. So in net, what we receive is 856 minus 340, that is 516 rupees. So our effective savings for that month is the energy cost that we have saved by generating our own energy, plus the amount that the DISCOM has compensated us for the excess energy that we have injected into the grid. So our net savings becomes about 1069 rupees. So this we have done for every month starting November 2019 to October 2021. In this 2 years, there has been a tariff revision 3 times. So our fixed cost has gone up from 340 to 465. Our energy cost also has actually the hypothetical cost of energy that we have actually had to pay to DISCOM if you are not to be having solar also has gone up in that same period. So if we accumulate all these, we will be saving an effective savings of about 33,000 rupees over the last 2 years. So what it means in terms of simple economics, we have our cost of the plant is about 250,000. Our simple return, that is 33,000 divided by 2, 16,700. So our rate of return is about 6.68%. That is still 2% higher than the bank rate. So it actually, the economy doesn't just end here. See, since the cost of the grid power keeps increasing every year, so the rate of return also keeps increasing. This is only for the last 2 years at that prevailing tariff. So as the tariff of the DISCOM increases, our return also increases. So we will now see another case. Say now in this case, we have taken our energy consumed as actuals. Now we will just take a hypothetical case where if our energy consumption were to be 350 units instead of our actual, say our energy consumption has actually increased and the production remaining the same, what would be the economic scenario? See, now take that for the same month, say November 2019, we have produced 325, however, we have consumed 350. So our net energy is, we have actually bought from the DISCOM 24 units of energy. So fixed cost remains the same. Okay, the cost of electricity at that particular month, November 2019, at the prevailing tariff, in November 2019, would have been 2321. Okay, so now, how much is the DISCOM pays us? They don't pay us anything because we have ended up buying from them. So this is zero. So we in turn actually have to pay to BESCOM or the DISCOM 90 rupees for the 24 units of energy that we have used. So in effect, what we have paid, 90 rupees plus 340, that is 430 rupees. So in this scenario, my effective savings becomes B, that is the cost of electricity without solar, minus E, that is energy cost for the consumer. So this hypothetically I have saved so much. However, I have to shell down this much because I have taken energy from the DISCOM. Plus, if at all the DISCOM pays anything, but in this case it is zero. So I have ended up saving about 1891. If you take the case of say April 2020, where my net energy is actually in the plus side. So I actually injected some energy into the grid. So this is positive here. So here in this case, my net savings becomes an addition of whatever I have received from DISCOM. So for example, in April 2020, I have received 332 rupees. So my effective savings becomes hypothetical cost of energy minus my fixed cost plus whatever I have taken from the DISCOM. So if we do same thing for every month and taking into account the change in tariff, which was announced thrice in the last 2 years. So there's a cost increase in energy cost, increase in fixed cost. My net savings, if my energy consumption were to be 350 units per month, is about 47,700 rupees. So what it means in terms of economics, cost of the plant remains same, 250,000, but my simple return, that is 47,000 divided by 2, that is 23,000, my rate of return becomes 9.5%. That is almost double than my bank rate of interest. So what in terms of economics, in terms of if somebody has to compare, see, my demand were to be more, see, if my demand were to be 350 units instead of 150, 100, 150, 200 units per month, if my demand were to be slightly higher, my return is far more. And this is, mind you, for only for 2 years. So as and when the DISCOM energy cost increases, my rate of return also increases. In conclusion, what it means, if your demand is higher, your return is higher. That is, if we match our demand to our solar capacity, our return will be slightly better, or it will be significantly better for that matter. So let us conclude this presentation. So in conclusion, in terms of energy, in terms of carbon footprint, rooftop solar is definitely the best. Okay, because more than anything else, the transmission and distribution losses is zero. In economic terms, feed-in tariff for Indian grid conditions really doesn't matter. If we are actually, if there's net metering allowed by DISCOMs, and if you are able to meet your demand by solar, the return is significant. We don't need to bother much about the feed-in tariff. Micro inverter is still a good bet, I would say, because you know, in terms of safety, there's no DC wiring, and you would also mean that, you know, there are discrete systems, so there are independent systems, so in future if there's a breakage, it becomes much easier to replace. Briefly, this is our conclusion. Thank you very much.